I'm here with Jörg Vogel, who is the chair of the Institute for Molecular Infection Biology in Würzburg and also an EMBO member since 2011. Thank you for taking the time to talk to us.
Thank you for the invitation.
Can you briefly explain, sort of in very basic term, what non-coding RNAs are and what their function is?
So non-coding RNAs are a large class of cellular transcripts that are not translated into proteins and are not tRNAs or ribosomal RNAs. And they serve a lot of different functions in the cell. They can act as antisense RNAs and regulate gene expression, but they can also interact with many proteins and be organizers of complexes in the cell.
And in particular, your research has been focusing on non-coding RNAs in bacteria as well as in infection, in host pathogen interactions.
Right.
Can you elaborate a little bit on where your research, in what directions your research are going?
Right, so the focus in the lab has been to understand small non-coding RNAs, we also call them the sRNAs, in pathogenic bacteria. And what we've discovered over the last 10 years or so, and that's not only my lab, but it also includes discoveries by many other labs, is that bacteria express many of these sRNAs, these small non-coding RNAs, and they regulate genes, and they regulate many genes, and it seems the scope of regulation is as broad as the level of transcription factors or DNA control.
Is it the same thrill of seeing an exciting result when you are a group leader than when you're actually doing the experiment? So if students in your lab get an exciting result and they come to you, do you sort of get the same thrill?
Definitely, and especially, I mean, if these people feel this themselves. So often, I mean, they realize they have found something new and they just can't wait to tell you. And that's just fantastic. I mean, this is what actually keeps you in science. And it's really like mentoring the next generation.
What directions would you like to see the research going, or what are you trying to, the directions you should go into?
So really want to understand why cells use non-coding RNAs instead of, for instance, transcription regulators or other regulatory proteins to control gene expression. And that will keep us busy for the next 10, for the next years to come. But at the same time, I think we've already learned a lot and have understood some of the basic principles of RNA-based regulation. And we should apply these principles and try to use RNA molecules to treat infections in the clinics, for instance. I mean, we are an aging society, and infections do pose a considerable threat to our health care system. So I think I want to make a contribution there as well.
And is there any questions you really would like to have the answers to? Like, is there something you really would like to know in 10 or 20 years?
To follow a small RNA from birth to death in a prokaryotic cell,
so
in a tiny little
it.
Cell,
right?
I want to see a single molecule from the second it's being made, it's transcribed, and I would like to be able to follow it on its way through the cell until it hits its target and then it disappears. That would be great.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.